Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a figure review on the Star Wars Attack of the Clones Coruscant Padme Amidala. Now, I pretty much already have reviewed all of my Padme figures, but I feel some need an updated review, so I will be doing that off and on. Any figures I feel that need an updated review, I'm just gonna do. So if you see two reviews of the same figure on my channel, it's just an updated review. So yeah, and there's quite a few figures that I think could use an updated review, just because my older videos weren't that great, and I want to make them better. So before we take a look at the figure, we're gonna take a look at the packaging. Now, as you guys know, I have all of the Padme figures loose and carded. You know, when a Padme figure comes out, I get two, one to open, to keep carded. I'm just a completist like that. And I'm gonna turn the light off for this. So I have her carded. This is a part of the Saga Blue card. Right there you can see the Star Wars logo. The lightsaber. I always say this is Luke's hand. It is. I miss. Definitely say it is, because he does that with his lightsaber. There is the figure in the bubble. It says withdraw action. There's a lovely picture of Natalie Portman as Padme. Then her Attack of the Clones, her name, and Coruscant Attack. Then on the back is the Star Wars logo, and a little read up on episode 2. A read-up on Padme herself. You guys can pause and read that. A pictures of the figures and what the figure does. And the other figures in the wave. I do have the Anakin. And I do have the Darth Maul. I don't have this Chewbacca. So, yeah. And then there's the Star Wars logo. Hasbro logo before we saw, the Disney logo on everything now. And on the side right here, it actually says what she comes with. And there's another Hasbro logo right there. And this figure came out in 2002. You guys can see, so it's been out for a while. So I'm just going to move the card back right over there. Let's get into the figure. Okay, so here's the figure. I'm going to start with her articulation. She has a swivel in the head, swivel on the shoulders, swivel on the forearm right here, swivel on the waist, swivel in the hips, and ball hinged knees. So not too much articulation, but at least she does have some ball hinged knees. So let's just take a look at her outfit. I think the outfit is nicely done. It's nicely done for the time. The sculpt is nice. You can see the sculpt right there. You can see her little belt right there. You can see her little tunic. You can see the folds and wrinkles on her suit or her back. Her pants have some pretty nice detail. They're just pretty much all one color. And her boots are nicely sculpted as well. The hair is very in movie accurate. Padme did have braids, but it wasn't just one single braid. It was a couple, I want to say like 4 braids. So I'm not sure why Hasbro didn't just make it, more movie accurate, but she didn't have just one braid if you watch episode 2. So that's a disappointing feature on the figure. The face sculpt, I think it's not a bad one. It does resemble Natalie Portman to an extent. It's an okay one. It's definitely better than others, so. Yeah, so. So let's look at her accessories, if she will stand. She doesn't come with a stand, so it's a little harder to get her to stand. I could have brought one, I suppose, but. And oh, I also forgot to show this little detail too. She has a pouch right there. I missed it. Pretty cool detail. Let's get her standing up. Her accessories are, of course, a helmet. Really nicely sculpted. Nicely detailed as well. And, of course, you can put it on her. I actually leave the helmet on her when I display her. Just because I have so many Padme figures, you know, this could, you know, you could use this one as a, you know, a regular pilot if you wanted to. And she also comes with a blaster. Again, nicely sculpted, nicely detailed. There are two things you can do. Obviously, you can do, put it in her hand. Like so. Or you can take it back out and you can plug it. There is a little hole right there. And you can plug it into that. Hopefully. I haven't really tried that. And I had this figure for a while. Let's see. Let me do it off camera. Huh. I think the peg is a little... Uh-oh, I just lost the gun! Alright. I think the peg is a little... On the blaster is a little too big, unfortunately. I never really tried it because I'm always having her hold it anyway. Let me just try a few more times. Alright, there we go. I got it in. So, like, so you can put it, plug it in on her outfit, which is, looks pretty cool, but I personally just have her hold it. Another accessory she comes with is this, what is it called? Radar dish. It's very nicely detailed. There is a gimmick to her. What it's supposed to do is it's supposed to explode into pieces. But what I did is I super glued it just because it is kind of hard to put back together. So I just super glued it. So now it's just its own piece. Doesn't really do anything except move. But it is nicely detailed and it looks pretty cool next to Padme right there. And it would be really cool on a Coruscant diorama if you did one. So, all in all, this is an okay figure. Not my favorite Padme figure, but obviously, since Padme is my favorite character, I definitely needed to add this one to my collection. I had the loose figure for a while, and actually I also had the carded figure for a while, too. She was actually one of my first carded figures, so. So, if you are a fan of Padme, or you just like the Episode 2 figures, I would, let me get this back in her hand. I would definitely recommend her for your Coruscant setup. But if you're not a huge Padme fan, as I am and as a few other people here on YouTube are, I'd probably skip this one. But she is cool and she's not holding her gun. There she is. And she is pretty nice to add to your collection. So today's review was on the Episode 2 Coruscant Padme Amidala figure. Thanks for watching. More videos will come soon. Bye.